But things were not peaceful on Friday night. And that brings us to our big story, which is Portland's status as an anarchist jurisdiction, at least in the eyes of the Trump administration, who made that term totally up. The president has made it clear, though, he is tired of the protests. And because he's so tired, he's slapping three American cities with that label and threatening to withhold federal funds from them. Which funding, you're probably asking? Well, that's not exactly clear. When might it happen? That's the natural follow-up. He's not saying. Does he have the power to do this? Well, most legal experts say no, he does not. But that has not stopped him before. And the leaders of these cities on the anarchist jurisdiction list are pushing back. Here's Maggie Vespa.
Portland's been burning for many years. For decades, it's been burning.
After months of launching fiery critiques at Portland, its protests, and its leadership, the Trump administration is doubling down on threats to withhold federal funding from the city. In a news release Monday morning, the Department of Justice dubbed Portland, along with Seattle and New York City, jurisdictions that are permitting anarchy, violence, and destruction. The release gave reasons for including each city. In Portland, that included, among other things, more than 100 nights of protests, dozens of which turned violent or destructive. Attorney General William Barr quoted in the release saying, "We cannot allow federal tax dollars to be wasted when the safety of the citizenry hangs in the balance." Local legal experts zeroed in on what's not included in the release.
Well, what I found surprising is that the list of cities came before detailing what the tangible repercussions might be. We still don't know what kind of grant programs the Trump administration is thinking about targeting.
Indeed, earlier this month, the president issued a memorandum threatening to cut federal grants to a number of cities, writing the feds fund a wide array of programs, such as housing, public transportation, job training, and social services. First and foremost, our experts point out, withholding funds is a constitutional power of Congress, not the president. It'll be tough, they say, for President Trump to argue that he has this power. Second,
there is a line of Supreme Court jurisprudence that says that the federal government can only influence so much state policy or local policy. The big example of that would be when Congress tried to expand Medicaid for all 50 states as part of the Affordable Care Act, or Obamacare as it's often called. And the Supreme Court struck that down by saying that, well, Congress can't make states expand Medicaid.
Other experts we spoke to cited the president's 2017 attempt to cut federal funds to sanctuary cities and states, demanding they enforce federal immigration policies. That attempt has been tied up in the courts since. Lewis and Clark law professor Tung Yin said, of course, that could happen again. If it does,
you know, I would rather have the side of Portland in that litigation to argue that this any cuts in funding like that would be unconstitutional. But litigation can take a long time to work through. And so for nonprofit groups and the people who benefit from those who are relying on that funding, to tell them, you know, in 3 or 4 years, you'll probably win the case, I'm sure is not going to be of great comfort at all.
Okay, Maggie Vespa joining us now. Maggie, I just feel like there's so much up in the air here. You have this ominous threat from the president. He's saying he's going to withhold funds. Experts are telling us he can't do that. It almost sounds like something that is probably headed to a courtroom somewhere before we learn much more. But are we hearing from the leaders of these cities, the mayor of Portland, for instance?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we'll start with the mayor of Portland. And, you know, Mayor Ted Wheeler, when President Trump first kind of lobbed these threats on Twitter, Mayor Ted Wheeler a couple of weeks ago was at a public event and reporters approached him about it. And his first reaction was to say, you know, I can't keep track of everything Donald Trump tweets. He tweets a lot. But then he went on to say he obviously had seen the statement and the tweet. And he said it made him really mad because the president was kind of, as we said, vaguely threatening funding tied to housing, funding tied to food, and funding tied to these essential services at a time when we're in a pandemic and there's record unemployment. So fast forward to today. The mayor called the DOJ's designation, quote, thoroughly political and unconstitutional. Then, referencing the pandemic again, he added, quote, what the Trump administration is engaging in now is more of what we've seen all along, shirking responsibility and placing blame elsewhere to cover its failure. end quote. And we're hearing similar responses from city leaders in Seattle and New York. And then today, also, the Attorney General of the state of New York announced that she's already preparing a lawsuit in case President Trump tries to go forward with this tied to funding in any capacity. But again, what we heard from our legal experts, what really baffles them is that there are no details tied to what funding he may be targeting, when that might happen, how much of the funding may be targeted. It's just this list of cities that are anarchist jurisdictions and then a list of reasons why each city is on that list. So again, as you said, so much up in the air, but that's just kind of where we are right now. So we'll see.
It stays in the air for the time being. All right, Maggie, thank you.